Hello children, ready for another story? Story title is Reba Wants Ice Cream. The story has been written by Sultana Zakia and the illustrations given by Diman Sarkar. Translations are done by Gauri Srinidhi and the book is being published by Room to Read. In the story, we are going to read about this girl who wants to buy an ice cream. And here, she teaches all of us a lesson. We will now go into the story and then see what it is. Ice cream, ice cream, the shopkeeper called. An ice cream salesperson sells his ice cream by calling ice cream, he's selling his ice cream. Reba ran to her mother. Ma, ma, I want ice cream. Finish your homework first, said ma. After hearing this sound, Reba ran to her mother and asked for a ice cream. But her mother said, go and finish your homework first, she said. Reba looked unhappy. Ma asked, are you done with your homework yet? No. But my notebook is full. I need to buy another one. When her mother refused to buy ice cream, Reba was so unhappy. Her mother asked her whether she has finished her homework. But she said, no, I have not. But my notebook is full. There is no empty paper in my notebook to do my homework, she said. She also added that she need to buy a new notebook to do her homework. Ma gave Reba 50 taka. Go buy a notebook. We also need a bar of soap. So taka, what does mean by taka? Taka is the name of currency used in Bangladesh. Like we all use rupees in India, in Bangladesh, their currency name is taka. So now, Reba's mother gave her 50 rupees and she said, go buy a notebook and buy one bar of soap because I need that one too. Did you all notice that instead of taka, I said rupees? So henceforth from this page, I will be saying rupees instead of taka. Reba went to the shop. The shopkeeper gave Reba a notebook and a bar of soap. How much? Asked Reba. Reba went to the shop and asked for a notebook and a bar of soap. Shopkeeper also gave and she asked how much she has to pay for that. The notebook is 20 taka and the soap is 20 taka, said the shopkeeper. That means the total cost is 40 taka. Here's your change. The cost of the notebook is 20 rupees and the soap cost is also 20 rupees. So total it comes to 40 rupees. The shopkeeper, after calculating 20 plus 20, 40, he gave the change to her. When Reba came back home, she calculated her change. Reba gave the shopkeeper 50 taka. The notebook was 20 taka and the soap was 20 taka. After returning back home, Reba calculated the change. I should only get 10 taka back, thought Reba. Why did the shopkeeper give me 20 taka back? When she calculated, she has to have only 10 rupees. 20 plus 20 equals 40. She gave 50 rupees to the shopkeeper. So 50 minus 40 equals 10 rupees. But the shopkeeper, by mistake, he has given 20 rupees back to Reba. Why did the shopkeeper give me 20 back? So she got confused. That's great, thought Reba. I can buy ice cream with this extra money. But Reba was ashamed of herself. I should go back and give the shopkeeper the correct change. When there was extra 10 rupees, Reba got an idea. Oh, I can buy an ice cream with this extra money. But immediately, she felt so ashamed that she should not cheat the shopkeeper, because only by mistake he has given extra 10 rupees. That 10 rupees does not really belong to Reba, right? She said to herself that I should go and give back the extra change to the shopkeeper. Reba rushed back to the shop. There were so many kinds of ice creams that she wanted. Oh, if only I could have an ice cream, she thought. When she returned back to the shop, she saw lots and lots of ice creams there. Various varieties of ice creams. She thought that I also could have had an ice cream. When Reba got to the shop, she saw another girl who had just bought ice cream. She was about to go home. The shopkeeper stopped her. Wait, he said, you have given me too much money. Come back, take the change. When Reba went to the shop, she saw a girl who was buying ice creams. And she was about to go home. But then the shopkeeper stopped her and said, oh, get the change and go. You have given me a lot of money here. The shopkeeper gave the girl a change. Reba stepped forward. You gave me 10 extra taka. Please take your money back. After the shopkeeper gave the change to that girl, Reba gave the shopkeeper the extra money by saying that it has come to her by mistake. You are such an honest girl. The shopkeeper was so happy with Reba's honesty that he gave her an ice cream for free. Reba happily licked her ice cream all the way home. This attitude of Reba's made the shopkeeper so happy. He appreciated Reba's honesty and he gave her an ice cream for free. Reba was so happy with the ice cream that she licked the ice cream throughout the way home. See, she is enjoying the ice cream and going back home. From this story, what is the lesson we learn? The lesson is honesty. We should always be honest. to everyone. See how Reba was honest to the shopkeeper, that she got appreciation from him, added to the free ice cream. Yes, we all also should follow the policy of being honest. Bye, children. Try these. Did Reba do the right thing by returning the extra money to the shopkeeper? What will you do if you are in the situation of Reba?